Hi everyone, Ulysses here for Microchip Technology. Welcome to Ask Our Experts, a series of videos where we answer some frequently asked questions on a diverse set of topics. Today's topic is about secure elements. And to help answer our question, we welcome back Todd Slack. So let's get started. Todd, JIL is a term used by Microchip when we promote our secure key storage solutions. It's also a term used by Common Criteria. But what does it mean?
JIL stands for Joint Interpretation Library. It is a globally recognized scoring system in the security community focused on basically determining how well you protect your keys in a secure element. In our case, we submit things like our Trust Anchor 100 for evaluation by an accredited security lab. So before they ever start trying to attack the device and extract keys, we provide them access to our design databases. They get access to our data sheets, user guides, programming specs, you name it. And then they figure out the best path on how they're going to try and attack your device. Now you get a set of scores when the clock starts, which is when they actually start trying to attack the device. The first set would be on how long it takes them to extract a key from a device, if in fact they can extract it. There's a score where if it's less than a day, you would get 0 points, but it would increment as you go to a week, a month, and so on. And ultimately, after 3 person months of trying to extract a key from a device, if they cannot extract that key, then they consider it impractical to extract a key from that device. And you would end up ultimately with a score of JIL high. Now, along the way, there are other things that you can get a score if in fact they can extract a key, say after a month, where you involve things like, what was the expertise of the person that attacked the device? Was this a recent college grad or one of a handful of people in the world that can perform the attack? Another set of points would be associated with the cost of the attack. Was this a $250 DPA board or a $500,000 piece of equipment that it took to extract the keys? How much were they dependent on documentation that's publicly available versus what was provided, say, under NDA? And then a number of different scores will add up ultimately from 0 to 31, 31 being the highest. So you can have basic, enhanced basic, moderate, and ultimately high. So devices like the Trust Anchor, where they were unable to extract a key after 3 person months, have achieved a score of JIL high. And that explains the JIL scoring assessment system.
Thanks, Todd. Always nice to have you. Viewers, to learn more about the Trust Anchor, make sure to check out our Crypto Automotive webpage linked in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.